by personal experiences, I mean, it is literally isn't that I saw that are vital that can, you know, it can equip you into like getting jobs, create NGOs.
I'm just
here to bring you information. So what you do with that information is solely up to you. Welcome to my channel. Igama lam ndinguSilindo Kuhle wakwaKwani. So if you're new here, welcome to my channel. Please subscribe and click on the notifications button so that you can get notifications whenever I upload a new video. And if you're a returning subscriber, hello and welcome back again. Thank you for subscribing and thank you for the interaction of the previous video. I think first of all, I need to apologize because I last posted a video, I think about 4 or 5 months back, and I promised that I'm going to upload another video, but I could not. The last 5 months have been incredibly busy. I think as you can see my outfit, I am not so new, but I'm a new bride. So it has been busy, wedding planning, attending the wedding and everything in between. Also have a job and also have these roles in between, being a mom, being a wife, being a friend, like everything in between. So it has been so busy that I literally like ending in a chance, you know, with work also. So I apologize and I hope you've forgiven me. Okay. So, the last time we spoke, I promised that I'm going to upload a video of short courses that I feel are vital for one in nursing, specifically primary health care. And specifically, I think it's not only important for a future job prospect, but also to equip you to become a better nurse and a more experienced nurse with like more knowledge, like evidence-based knowledge, and yeah, to make you a great practitioner overall. I took the liberty to also ask two profound midwives, a midwife actually and a cashier. So I asked them also about like what other short courses are vital in midwifery to equip one in order to become like their best midwife that they could be, you know, with more experience. And yeah, so with the information that I gathered, please note that it is literally related to like personal experiences. By personal experiences, I mean it is literally isn't that I saw that are vital that can, you know, it can equip you into like getting jobs, create NGOs. I am not promoting anyone to go work for NGOs or anything, but I mean, I've worked for NGOs before and we have conducted interviews, and I actually saw like which short courses that we looked for from certain candidates. So there are courses that you can actually like do for yourself without having to wait for your institution to send you for your short courses. I think we spoke previously and I said that, you know, with the burden of the health system year two, we often do not get like to be sent for your courses as often as we'd like to be. So if you do have extra cash, guys, I really encourage you to get short courses. And the nice thing with some of these short courses is you don't even have to go to where they plan. If the short course is offered, for example, say by UPE or whatever university or whatever company, you don't have to go there. You can literally do them online, complete it online, and then ufumane certificate after that. Capish? Done. So some of them, they might be difficult to do online. It might require you to do like case studies and a lot of reading, a lot of like interactive things, but believe me, equipping yourself with knowledge and with education is not something that, you know, that's a waste, in my opinion. So and secondly, I'm not affiliated to any of the companies that offer the short courses. And besides, I don't know them. They don't pay me or anything. But when I looked through the internet, when I was like looking for information, I saw which companies actually offer the short courses. I will not have information about how much the short courses cost, and also like when do you register and everything. So if you need more information, please kindly contact the place or the company that offers the short course. I'm just here to bring you information. So what you do with that information is solely up to you. So I will not know anything. And also, as I said, this is solely based from like personal experience. So you might feel as if this is not true in your own opinion. That's okay. We don't have to agree about your kinder. But yeah, so I'm just going to jump right into it. And before I give you the list of the short courses, I think it's about 16. It's not a lot. But the other vital thing that you need to equip yourself with is the guidelines. Please, guidelines, updated guidelines, not just any guidelines. Like, always check the guidelines if they are being updated, and always read the latest guidelines. You can download guidelines on your phone. You can have them on your desk. Facilities sometimes like freely give you guidelines. So as short courses get, guys, as I said, primary healthcare, and also just a few from midwifery. So the first one is nurse initiated management of antiretroviral therapy, which is also known as UNIMAT. I think UNIMAT is commonly known, and yeah. So UNIMAT is offered by AquaH Training School. It is offered by the South African HIV Clinician Society. It is also offered by Health Systems Trust. And it is also offered by Health Science Academy, which is also known as HSA. So you can contact any of these training schools and ask them about UNIMAT, their prices, and also for how long can you do the UNIMAT course for, and whatever the requirements that you need to, you know, to know about. The second course that I feel is quite vital is a dispensing course. Dispensing course, UNIMAT. Don't say I didn't tell you. So a dispensing course, you can also get it from AquaH Training School. You can also get it from Health Advanced Institute. You can also get it from HSA. Foundations for Professional Development, also known as FPD. You can also get it at Public Health Institute of South Africa, and it is also offered by the University of Limpopo. And with these short courses, so if you subscribe, lack of a better word, if you subscribe to any of these training schools, so they will keep sending you notifications to tell you if there's any discounts on these courses. So please also find out if there's any discounts that they offer. And sometimes they say that you can like come in groups. So if, say, maybe you come as a group of 10, then they give you a discount, that sort of thing. So just find out more from them. And then there's also Integrated Management of Child Illnesses, which is also known as IMCI. You can get IMCI from AquaH Training School, and you can also get it from FPD. And there's also a postgraduate diploma in HIV and AIDS management that you can do at Stellenbosch University, and also a postgraduate diploma in clinical management of HIV and AIDS, that you can do at the University of Forte. So I know with this postgraduate diplomas, that you sometimes, if you have like a dispensing course, then if there's like an element in the modules of the postgraduate diploma that has like dispensing course that you need to do, or like dispensing that you need to do, Then if you have already like a dispensing course, then you can get exempted. Or if you maybe are waiting to be accepted, then you can probably do like a dispensing course. Remember, this is all personal experience. If you feel otherwise, that's also okay. Then you can also do a postgraduate diploma in social and behavioral studies, which is focused on HIV and AIDS. I think it is offered by UCT. I stand under correction, I'm not sure. And they also said there's a postgraduate diploma in TB and HIV management, also offered by UCT. So you need to call these universities to find out when applications open and how much, yeah, so that you can facilitate getting these qualifications. Okay, you can also do nurse initiated management of drug resistant TB, which is also known as being a NIMDR nurse. I think this is a very vital course too, because many NGOs, especially those that are dealing with TB, are looking for NIMDR nurse trained nurses. So you can do that at FPD. You can also do an HIV AIDS, STI and TB management course that is also offered by Aqua Training School. And you can also do a tuberculosis management and control that is also offered by South African Health Clinician Society and APC. Okay, with APC and PC101, yeah, in the Eastern Cape, sorry, they call it PC101, and I think the side would call it APC. Yeah, I think so. So with APC, you can get it from K2 Online School. So with the K2 Online School, this is a free course that you can literally just subscribe to K2 Online School. You do the case studies and then you complete them. Then you get your APC certificate or your PC101 certificate, depending on the province that you are in. Yeah? So just... remember, I speak under correction and clarity. Just check which province that you are in and which is applicable, either APC or PC101. Then you can subscribe at K2 Online and also look at other courses that they offer and do them. It's literally just, it's free, it's online. And then a Knowledge Hub. Knowledge Hub is very important. Like constantly checking on Knowledge Hub, the latest guidelines, the latest updates, the latest information in terms of management and patient management, like evidence-based practice, like evidence-based patient management, Knowledge Hub. You literally just go online to Knowledge Hub and you'll get every guideline that you need downloaded on your phone, on your PC, whatever. You can just freely get it there. And if there's any courses that are coming up, there's like a section for short courses that you can click on, where you can see what short courses or webinars that are currently happening, workshops, online workshops. There's a lot that you can actually get from Knowledge Hub. I urge you to acquaint yourself with Knowledge Hub. You're literally not going to regret it. And then you can get like a prep certificate from myprep.co.za. It's also a free website where you literally go to myprep.co.za and then you read up about the prep program and also answer a few questions after you have read up. And then you get yourself a certificate. And then you can also do a short course in sexually transmitted infections, which you can do with FPD. And now coming to the midwifery side. So this is information that I got from my two very experienced advanced midwives, actually. This information I got from advanced midwives. The other advanced midwife has got masters in midwifery. So please, this information is more than accurate. So, and the other midwife, AquaH, is actually a advanced midwife, was a lecturer in midwifery. So please, the information is more than accurate, okay? So they said that you can actually do ESMO. Do ESMO is an essential steps in management of obstetric emergencies. I saw on the internet that Life College and Learning actually offers this course, and when I looked on the internet, I additionally saw that I think Stellenbosch University offered it previously via StelMed. I'm not sure, you can just find out from StelMed or Stellenbosch University if you cannot equip yourself with this course. So if you, then your facility is not sending you, then you can literally just go as a group of people so that you're more equipped to be a better midwife, hopefully an advanced midwife in future. Oh yeah. And then there's also the HBB, which is helping babies breathe course. I think it's also offered by a private company, but mostly people, they are given this course like in the public, or not even the public, even the private sector. Hospitals do offer, but if there is any way that you can like do the short courses like online without having to wait for your facility, please do. And then they spoke about MSSN, which is management of sick and small newborns. So if you want to be the best midwife and you want to keep yourself with like better knowledge, please find out more. I don't know, I couldn't find a place that offers it, but yeah. And they also lastly spoke about obstetric ultrasound. And I think they said previously NMMU offered it. Well, now NMU. Nelson Mandela University offered it. So you can also find out from Nelson Mandela University if they have this course still freely available. From me, thank you for watching, thank you for taking your time to watch and listen to me, and please just let me know what else I can like speak to you guys about, what you feel is important, what you feel you need to be equipped on, and I'm going to do my research, and yeah, we can speak or even have like a Q&A. Like you can just tell me like what interests you. I wish you all the best on your journey. And just hit me up if you need anything. And please don't forget to subscribe.